Yep. You guys have seen the title. You've seen the thumbnail. It is true. I can't believe these words are coming out of my mouth. I have indeed ordered a brand new Ford GT. I can't believe it. I can't believe I got an allocation. B, I can't believe it's in theory actually happening. I will explain everything, the whole story to you, how it happened, how I got the allocation, and step by step the whole process in this video. But I wanted to just use this because I knew maybe a few of you would be, you know, looking forward to this video and waiting for it. I wanted to use this as a platform also. I've been thinking what's one way that we could help people other than the people directly around us in the house, and what platform would be best to do that. And I've decided to use my platform being Get, which is a company I started a few years ago, where we usually give away things such as luxury holidays or mobile phones or computers, things like that. We've decided to put together what we're calling the quarantine pack, which anyone can play for, anyone can win. It's a pack with a TV, PlayStation, Netflix subscription, Amazon subscription, loads of cool things. Basically a full setup so that if you're stuck at home, you have everything you possibly could dream of. And all of the profits, every single cent made on this, is being donated to the Red Cross, local Red Cross. So wherever you decide to play from, you will then be donating at the same time to your local Red Cross to help the community that's directly around you. So I've put a link in the description down below. Be awesome if you guys could take part. Obviously it's great for us all to do what we can to help the people around us, the direct community that's very close to us. So yeah, we've put that together and I wanted to share it with you in this video. However, let's talk about the Ford. You're probably very confused. To be honest, as am I. This has been an ongoing thing for a little while now, but I wasn't sure how to talk about it, when to talk about it, what the right timing was. This may not be it. I don't know, but we're stuck at home and I figured, well, we might as well talk about it now. What happened is probably about 2 years ago, Ford came out with the application. It may even be more than that, maybe 3 years ago. Came out with the application form so that anyone could basically apply to buy a Ford GT. Now, super, super exclusive car, 647 horsepower, EcoBoost engine, but obviously, you know, the story of the Ford GT arcs back to a legendary Le Mans winning car in the 60s, who was then brought back around 2005 with a remake Ford GT. And then recently it was released, kind of third generation version of that car, which was super hard to get your hands on. So even some big Ford collectors haven't been able to get an allocation for one of those. They wanted to make it as exclusive as possible and even made buyers sign a contract saying that you're not allowed to sell the car for up to 2 years after taking delivery of it. They were very clear that they wanted people who would use the cars, drive them, not garage queen them, but also people who potentially had a presence on social media or were well-known traditional celebrities that would kind of get PR for Ford for this legendary car they just made. Many, many people applied. A lot of people I know applied, and I did. Back in the day, 2-3 years ago, I thought, I mean, you know, cross that bridge if we get there. If I get an allocation, I'll figure it out. But, you know, I probably won't. Super unlikely. Everyone I knew, apart from Shmi, the YouTuber, had not gotten one. Even, you know, there's a friend of mine I know who has two 2005 Ford GTs, did not get an allocation. So I applied, thought nothing of it, completely forgot, to be completely honest. Never even, you know, looked for a reply after that. I just figured, whatever, you know, I probably didn't get it. A year or two went by, and a couple of months ago, I get an email. Here is the email. We'll put it on the screen right now, right? So I just opened my email box. Dear Sebastian, congratulations. We are writing to notify you that you've been selected for the opportunity to purchase a new Ford GT. Your passion for performance and the Ford GT qualifies you to be among a small numbers of drivers selected for this opportunity. In the coming weeks, the Ford GT concierge team will contact you regarding the next steps in your exciting journey to Ford GT ownership. There is no action required of you at this time, but please feel free to contact us at blah, blah, blah. If you have any questions in the meantime, much like the finely crafted Ford GT, our concierge team will provide a unique customer experience from the initial ordering process through delivery and ownership. Once again, congratulations on being selected for this rare opportunity to own a piece of Ford history. Sincerely, the Ford GT team. And I panicked. I couldn't believe it. I started to look. I was like, is this a prank? What's going on? I couldn't believe it. I was thinking, oh my God, I applied like 2 years ago, completely forgot about this, and now I've been accepted for this. Such an honor to be accepted, obviously, for a Ford GT. Yeah, that truck, I have no idea why I got selected. Not a clue. I mean, I've been thinking about it. I'm like, you know, there's people I know who have a much larger following, who have other similar cars. I've never owned a Ford in the past. I mean, the only things I can kind of see is, I guess there's a small following online, but then also I've never garage queened a car. I've always driven cars quite a bit, and obviously I would do that with the Ford GT. Clearly it's on a completely different level to anything I've owned before, which brings us on to the Seb, how the hell are you gonna afford this? that's another thing quite figured out yet. So I figured I'd make this video, tell you about the whole process, tell you about how it came about, be completely open with you guys. I confirmed the order. That was a few months ago, so there's been a few steps that have been taken forward with that. The car will be at end of 2021 delivery. Now, you don't get too much more info. You kind of wait for your updates to come through the mail. I figured I might as well, you know, order the car, confirm it. At the moment, they're selling for overs. They've been selling for way, way over. But then what happened is they've made a few batches of these cars. So they're kind of making more than we originally thought they would. So where I'm sat now, and this is where I want to be completely open with you guys, is, you know, I made this video, the title, the thumbnail, all that stuff. You know, I've ordered a Ford GT, which indeed I have. Now, what's going to happen with that order, I don't know yet. I just want to be completely open. So currently, right now, as I said in my last video on Friday, I fully intend on taking delivery of the car. It gives me enough time to kind of save up and work on a way of being able to afford the car. Obviously, I would need to finance it and not you know, kind of buy it outright. But it depends on a lot of things. Effectively, how many of these are going to be made? If there are more batches which are made afterwards and it's a car, you know, I'm not going to flip it, but I also can't afford to, you know, lose £200,000 or something on a car that would depreciate. So if there are loads and loads being made and the Ford GT market looks like it's kind of going to crash, then at that point, of course, I'll reconsider the purchase just purely because it's a lot of money and I just can't afford or wouldn't be able to afford to lose a bunch on that car. So if it seems safe that it will hold its value decently, you know, I'm not necessarily in it to like make a bunch of money. I just don't want to lose too much. Then yes, why not? Obviously, I'd keep the car for a year, 2 years. I haven't had anything sent to me about a contract yet about having to keep it, but I would keep it for a while anyways, put a bunch of miles on it, really enjoy the car. But as I say, it depends on kind of whether they make a bunch more and that kind of kills the price of those. You know, Shmi 150, for example, he said he's never selling the car, so he doesn't care about the value, doesn't care if it goes down, it doesn't really affect him too much. Whereas for me, it'd be different. I'd be financing the car. It would obviously be a bit of a stretch to get it, so I want to make sure that it's not going to be a bad financial situation. So that's kind of variable number one. Variable number two is the car market as a whole. Obviously, right now with the coronavirus, no one really knows what's happening to the car market as a whole. So if it's just a really bad time, it kind of seems like it's panning out to get a car next year, end of next year, the market's crashed, the car's way under list, all these things, of course I'd reconsider. Then there's just the personal business side of things where we've definitely taken a hit through corona. And, you know, would it be a smart decision? Would I be able to afford the payments? If so, would I be overstretching myself for them? All these things there's a lot of questions effectively. So there's a few things which would need to go right in order for it to happen, which I see happening, to be honest. Right now, I'm very, very confident. Corona's obviously been a bit of a step back. You know, 2 months ago, I was like, yeah, no, of course, like this is what's going to happen. We have a few work projects which are growing nicely, and this has kind of put a halt to that. So this has kind of put everything up in the air. So rather than tell you guys it's happening, I've spec'd it, it's arriving, no problem, and then kind of pulling out at the last minute and you guys being like, well, what's happening here? I'd rather warn you, most likely still get the car, but just be completely open in the process. Because I can imagine a lot of you are also like, how have you gone? Lotus, R8, Scud, and then Ford GT. I'm asking myself the same question. I'm actually pinching myself. I mean, that's another point. Who knows what will happen with the other cars? If this arrives in 21 and I decide, you know, this is more my priority over the Scud or the R8, or maybe those will have changed by then. Obviously, one of those may go. I would love to be able to keep them, but we'll see. It's in quite a while, so there's quite a few variables that could come in place. However, it's a Ford GT. I managed to get an allocation. So, I mean, first of all, thank you, Ford. I have no idea why you picked me, to be completely honest, but I really, really appreciate it. We're going to go through this journey together. So I want to give you regular updates. I'm going to be studying the market, of course, and we're going to make this decision together. So currently, car's ordered, on the way, and we'll just be keeping track here on the channel on what's happening with the car, what's happening with the car market. Would this be a wise decision? Am I keeping the Scud? Am I selling the R8? But also along the way, we're going to do things such as speccing the car. You know, I'm going to do my own personal spec. Maybe down the line, I decide I want to bring someone else in the buying process with me to go 50-50 on the car. So then we would spec the car with that person. We'll see. We'll kind of like improvise as we go along. But yeah, I'm pretty pumped. I think that's pretty much everything. Was that pretty clear?
Yeah.
I mean, when this came through the email, I was so, so, so pumped. It's one of my favorite cars. Always, always loved the story behind the Ford GT. Always loved the way it looks, especially this new one. And I think you can do some crazy stuff with the spec. And I wouldn't really want to hold back if we ended up going for one and speccing it and doing all that stuff. I think, you know, if you're getting a car kind of that level, you might as well go all out. So, I mean, that's pretty much it. Ford GT 2021, it's been ordered. Everything looks in place for it to happen, but you have the full story, you have the full background, and I guess we'll take it from there. And updates will be coming soon. Please comment down below what you think of the car. Please comment down below any spec ideas you have. We'll try probably during quarantine still to do a spec video because there's an online configurator. And any new messages that come by, any updates that come, I will keep you updated on the Ford GT buying experience, which I'm so excited about. And I really hope I don't get in trouble for doing, but no one's told me not to, so you know. Anywho, that's that. Also, if you want to join this whole adventure, probably click that subscribe button down below because 73% of you that are watching this channel are still not subscribed. So if you feel like joining us on this adventure, please subscribe down below. It really helps the channel. Little thumbs up as well. And I'll be seeing you again very soon. Thank you guys so much for the support you always show me. And yeah, I'm pretty pumped. Bye-bye.